dear fellow Toastmasters and guests. Today, I wouldn't like to speak with you about the 14th of February or the coming 23rd of February or 8th of March and other parties. And instead, I would like to talk with you about movies. As you know, on February 26th, it will be the Oscar Awards. Do you know which was the year when the Oscar Awards were first granted? Maybe somebody knows? Well, actually it was in 1929. So, dear fellow Toastmasters, I would like you to give the award for the movies that you liked during the year of 2011. We will have some nominations for the best movies of 2011, and I would like to start with the award of best movie of 2011. Would someone like to give this award? Maybe someone has a movie that impressed him during the last year. Alla, please.
The best movie I saw last year was Helen by our outstanding young producer and director Andrei Zviagintsev. And I think it's a greatest pity that due to some intrigues it wasn't put forward to Oscar as the best foreign film. And as a result, that famous in brackets film Citadel, of course, didn't win anything. Yes. That's why my strong conviction is that Helen is the best film of the year.
Thank you very much. And now we are going to the next award. It will be the best animated movie of 2011. Does someone like animated movies here?
Yes,
of course. Well, if nobody else wants to get to the floor, Denis will give his award. But as Henry told me not strictly prohibited me to give you the floor, I would like to ask someone else.
Okay, I still can.
Okay, you're welcome.
It is your will.
Okay.
Actually, yes, I do love animated movies per se. But the problem with me, I already won the award master, I guess. One of the day award. But the problem is, I actually love, there is a very spiritual, very deep philosophical animated movie, Kung Fu Panda. And I love watching it over and over again. Unfortunately, I don't know about modern animated movies, but I would give Kung Fu Panda...
The Kung Fu Panda Part 2.
It was, to be not very politically correct, trash. So, but let it be Kung Fu Panda 2, because Kung Fu Panda 1 was actually a rather good movie. I recommend all of you watch Kung Fu Panda. It is a very deeply philosophical movie, worth watching.
Okay. Actually, I watched this movie when it first came to our country. It was about four years ago, I think. And the Kung Fu Panda second part, I didn't like it.
Told you it was trash.
So, now, we will go to the next award, and it will be the best actress in leading role.
In 2011?
Yes, Dmitry, please.
I would like to tell you about a movie which impressed me greatly in 2011. And it is movie Blue Valentine. I don't know if any one of you have seen it, but it is a very strong drama about relationship and about how it is difficult to save relationships in our daily life routine. So, the best actress. This movie is about a pair of young people, a man and a woman. And they met each other and they get married, and then they trying to save their marriage, to save their life. So the actress which was starring in this film is Michelle Williams. Maybe you don't know her either, but she's a very talented young actress. And a couple of weeks ago, the film which is called 7 Days with Marilyn Monroe started in Moscow, and she is playing Marilyn Monroe there. So I would like all of you to know this actress, because she's very talented and her acting is wonderful. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
I completely agree with you that Michelle Williams is a great actress. About 2 weeks ago I saw her last movie, 7 Days with Marilyn, and I enjoyed it very much. It was impressive. So, we are going to the next award, Best Visual Effect.
They are never able to ask it. And so it happened that only yesterday I managed to see some film, so-called in English, Lost in Translation, but in Russian, Трудности перевода. I have never seen it before. I saw it yesterday, and during yesterday's day and today, I'm thinking of it, in spite of the fact that there is nothing interesting, nothing special, and nothing unusual in this film. Nevertheless, I was thinking, and I thinking of this time and go back, and I'm thinking about the actresses and actors, and probably, of course, it's the main role of Coppola who produced this film. But I recommend, if somebody, anybody doesn't see, please go and join me in seeing it.
Scarlett Johansson.
Yes, it's the scene is made in Tokyo,
mm-hmm.
But it's very important. But it's beautiful, beautiful scenes of streets and in the nature of Tokyo. But it's a long film.
About Scarlett Johansson, do you know that she also participated in the casting for the movie 7 Days with Marilyn, but Michelle Williams won in that casting. And by the way, speaking about her too, not so long time ago I saw a movie by Woody Allen, Match Point, and it is a great movie with Scarlett Johansson, and I highly recommend you to watch this movie. It is actually one of the best movies that I have seen in the last years. Did you also like it?
Very much.
Yes, it's great.
Mm-hmm.
So, I think that we have come to the nomination of the best director of 2011. Who would you give this nomination? Sergei, I know that you're with me.
I think that the best director of 2011 is Lars Trier for his movie Melancholia.
Mm-hmm.
The movie is the best movie of the year. Best actress is Melancholia. But the question was who is the best director, and I think Lars Trier is.
Yes, actually I also like this movie. I saw it last weekend and and I was very impressed by the way that Lars von Trier presents the nature and this planet Melancholia. So, which movie do you think is the best foreign language film? Speaking about not Russian movies, but movies from another country. Please.
The film I'm liking this year was the film of Almodovar. Our skin, or like skin which we eat, something like that.
Skin which we live in.
Yeah, exactly.
Skin. I'm living.
No.
Okay. Okay.
I left the intrigue there. I will not tell you what the film is about if you haven't seen it, for you lose the intrigue, for you start watching it and you know how it will end, and there's a great intrigue there about the skin and about the girl, which you can see maybe on the billboards everywhere when it was shown. It's Spanish film. I like these I like this director much also.
What is his name?
Almodóvar.
I was shocked in the end of this movie when the intrigue was finished. Yes, I think that you would like also to participate.
Yes,
to give. Yes, of course. You're welcome.
Thank you. You know, I've always had a dream to travel in time and to see my favorite writers, but I never managed to. And I always dreamt about living in another time because I think this time is. And this year I saw a wonderful movie, maybe you saw it, it's called Midnight in Paris by Woody Allen. And I think the message of this movie just appealed to me, and it showed me that every generation dreamed of living in another generation, in the previous one, and we always think that other generations were better, but it's not the truth. So I think this movie is the best one. At least it influenced me a lot.
Actually, Dania, after watching this movie, I was very interested in Ernest Hemingway and about his literature, and I began to read his books. And thanks to this movie, I found an excellent writer. We are coming to another nomination, and it is the nomination of Best Supporting Role.
Supporting?
Yes. Supporting. It means that it is not the principal role.
A role of secondary importance.
Yes, a role of secondary importance. Who would like to give this nomination?
Try another one.
Oh, thank Dmitry, please.
Good evening again. I would like to tell you about the movie which was nominated not this year but the previous year, and it is the movie The King's Speech. Yes. It is a great movie about the King of England, who is, had problems with his addiction. He has a stammer, and the best supporting role goes to the person who is playing his teacher, who helps him to overcome his stammer, and it is Geoffrey Rush. Geoffrey Rush, this Australian actor, and it is one of the best supporting role performances which I've seen for the last years. So that's it.
May I add a little bit
of course.
It's a I have seen some Western films. So this King speech, and you see, it seems to me, and I think it's not only my opinion, that the role of this logoped is the main one in this film. King is a supporting role.
So, dear friends, I think that we had a very interesting discussion. We discussed movies, and I think that it is a real pity that Margarita Rindina is not now with us, because I know that she knows all the movies, and if you want to have some advice of which movie to see, you should consult Margarita.
Wow.
well, and now I will give the floor to our general evaluator.